Check the screen. Is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we have started that is design of footings. In that square footing, and in your syllabus they clearly mentioned single column footing means isolated footing to be designed. And as for the IS 456 2000, they are clearly mentioned because of that only we need to design the entire footing with the detailing, that is with the reinforcement calculation you need to do. And here the problem will be given like this: design a square footing for a column size of 400 by 400 to carry a load of 1200 kilonewton. The SBC of the soil is 220 kilonewton per meter square. Use M20 concrete and Fe415 steel. So these are the details will be given. So sometimes what they do is, instead of giving SBC of a soil, sometimes they may give the values of C, pi or the unit weight of the soil. In that case, what you have to do, you know the how to calculate the SBC of the soil by using the Tarzaghi's equation that we have used in a previous module, that is a bearing capacity of the soil. The formula will be what? Can anyone tell? CNC plus
S QNQ
QNQ plus
0.5 gamma V into N gamma.
Gamma
B, sir.
Gamma, capital B. Gamma S into B, N
into N gamma.
Okay. So this formula to be used, then you have to get safe bearing capacity. Okay. So after getting a safe bearing capacity from this formula, then that bearing capacity of soil to be used for the design of footing. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay, this is very, very important. Suppose if they not given directly SBC of the soil, you have to utilize this formula, then you have to get the SBC of the soil, then you have to use that SBC of the soil for the design of the footing. So in previous class, we have calculated that is size of the footing. So we have obtained the size of the footing as 2.5 meter by 2.5 meter. Then we have calculated the actual soil pressure, which is acting under the footing. That also we have calculated. Then after that, so we have calculated where the bending moment is critical. That is a critical section, that is at the face of the column, it is more critical. Then about that, we have calculated the bending moment. So this was the formula to be used to calculate the bending moment about the critical section. So at the face of the column will be critical, that is XX. Then this is actual soil pressure which is acting underneath the footing. And when we have taken about this section, that is about XX, see here, about XX, if you take the bending moment, then this is the formula we get. So this we have obtained. And after that, so we have calculated how much is the bending moment. So this was the bending moment we have obtained. Then from the bending moment criteria, we have calculated the depth of the footing required, or thickness of the footing required. That is where to use according to IS 456-2000, it will be MU equal to MU limit. The MU limit formula will be 0.138 FCK BD square. So from this formula, you will be getting the depth. So this is the actual required, but for the shear consideration and all, so we have increased the depth to 600 mm. That is overall depth we have adopted 600 millimeter. In that we have taken 60 millimeter as the cover for the reinforcement. So here I given a note, for the shear consideration, the depth of footing is increased up to 600 mm, because it may satisfy the bending moment criteria, but when we are going to check the shear, that is a one-way shear or a two-way shear or punching shear, in that case sometimes it may fail also. So before that, only on safer side, I have increased the depth up to 600 mm. Again, that is left to the designer based on the judgment and all, you can provide the depth. So just I increased it up to 600. Then out of that, we have taken the 60 millimeter diameter, cover. Then the effective depth becomes 600 minus 60. It was, this is the effective depth. Then after that, so we have calculated area of reinforcement also. So this is the formula to be used according to the IS 5456-2000.5 FCK B into D divided by FY into bracket 1 minus square root of 1 minus MU into 4.6 FCK BD square. So in this B here, BD, what we are using, suppose if you are using per meter, then you have to substitute here as a 1 meter or 1000 millimeter. So since I have taken here entire width of the footing, that's why I substitute directly 2500 here. Same here also you have to substitute directly 2500. Okay. So in your RCC at your UG level and all, you might have substituted 1000 here because you have taken there per meter. But here I have taken for completely one entire width of the footing. Then I have taken 16 mm dia bars. You may take 12 mm also, okay, for the footing. For the 16 mm dia bar, the spacing required is 238, but I have provided 235. So according to the code, the maximum to be provided is 300, which will be lesser than the 300 mm. Hence, I have provided 235. For the 235 mm center to center spacing, then the actual area provided via per calculated, this is the actual area of the reinforcement provided. Okay, I think till here we have calculated yesterday, right?
Yes, yes.
Okay. So after this, so those who have missed the class, you can watch the video uploaded. Okay. Next, what is the next step? Check for
shear, sir.
Shear. We have to do the check.
One way shear.
Yes, one way shear first. We'll do the one way shear. Then we'll go for the two-way shear. Right on. First, check for one-way shear. Next step. Step number. What is step number?
Three, sir.
Okay. Step number three. Step number three. Check for one-way shear. Means along one axis it may fail. Check for the one-way shear. So here the critical section for write down the critical section for one-way shear. One-way shear occurs at a distance of D from the face of the column, from the face of the column. Okay. But this is the column provided and this is the footing. So from the face of the column, it is at a distance of D. Here is a critical section. Understood? I think it's visible to you all.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Please note it down. So from the face of the column, have marked as a xx. At this xx point, the shear, that is one way shear, is more critical or maximum, you can call. Then if the width of the column is B and this entire width of the footing is what? B, capital B. And the depth, what we have provided is a D, effective depth. Then what is this distance?
Sir, B minus capital B minus small b divided by 2.
Yes, this one. Okay. Then after leaving D, what could be this distance? Tell me.
Sir, one second, please tell us.
Hmm?
Sir, even held distance.
E distance held. This distance from the xx till here.
Sir, capital B minus B by 2 minus B.
Minus D.
Minus D.
Yes, correct. Okay. This much you have to mark. That is B minus B by 2 minus D. Then you can easily calculate the shear force. So actually the here, how much is the, that is a bearing pressure here? We have calculated actually. That is P naught.
That is 288.
That is 288. P naught, right? That we have marked as a P naught. Okay. That you write it. Then from this, so leaving this part, that is left side part, you leave it. About xx, you need to take the shear force. I hope you're understanding.
Sir.
About this one, about this point. Can you see this one?
Yes, sir.
About this point, about xx, you need to calculate the shear force because this is the maximum. I hope you understood.
Yes, sir. Got it.
Now I'll write. I'll get directly factored shear force. Because why I factored? Because already I made it factored. this SBC, I already have made it factored. You just check out the previous step. Okay. So I'll write factored shear force, that is VU, how much it is? P naught
into b minus b divided by 2 minus p.
Yes, correct. Then, but I have taken it for the entire width. I have taken it for the entire width. Like this. Are you getting? Multiply by?
Yes, sir. B by 2
Oh, B, B,
into
not
b.
B.
Okay.
Understood, all of you? All of you
Yes,
understood
sir.
this
Yes,
one?
sir.
Any doubt here? See, the entire footing is lifting like this because of the shear. Entire width. That's why I've taken it as completely B. Suppose if you are taking per meter, then you multiply it by 1 meter. But I am not multiplying by 1 meter. I am multiplying by entire width. I hope you understood.
Yes, sir.
Yesterday I have shown that one. Previous class. See here. It will be lifting like this. Like this. Then it is completely width. This width. Right? Then. After this. Substitute all the values here. P naught is how much? P naught. That is a pressure of the
288, sir.
288 into bracket
2.5 minus 0.4.
2.5 minus 0.4.
0.4
That small b
divided
is
by 2.
the column width divided by 2 minus
540.
540. That is 0.54 into
2.5.
that. So what is the
So we
shear
are getting in minus 388 something.
minus,
Ah, sir.
how come it is minus? Check it. What is the answer? Calculate and tell me answer.
367.2.
Yes, 367.2
2.
kilonewton. Okay, right on. Then you have to calculate nominal shear stress. Okay. Then you have to calculate. Is it over?
Yes, sir.
Calculate nominal shear stress according to the
Okay.
code. Tau we calculate. Page number 72. Nominal.
VU divided by B into D.
Yes. Page nominal. Page number 72. IS 456 2000. Okay. So here I'll show you that. Is it visible?
Yes, sir.
This one. The nominal shear stress in beams of uniform depth, or you can have footing also, you have to take the same. Okay. Tau V equal to VU divided by B into D. Okay. Where VU is the shear force to the design loads, and B is the breadth, and D is the depth to be taken. So here I'll write tau v equal to vu divided by b into d. So b into d means this b should be taken the footing width, not the column width. You can take it as a capital B also here. Okay. So 367.2 into 10 divided by 2500 taken millimeter into 540. What is the answer you get, tau e?
0.27, sir.
0.2
72.
newton per millimeter square. Right on this one. Newton per millimeter square. Okay. Then you calculate percentage of a steel required. Percentage of steel required. So percentage of steel required, you need to calculate. That is by using this one. Which one? This formula. Can you see this one? For the percentage of steel, this is the percentage of steel required minimum. And for this, we calculate tau c value. Okay. Calculate first percentage of steel required, percentage of steel, that is PT 100 AST divided by again B into D. The capital D I'm taking 100. What is the area of steel provided?
Then we have to calculate AST provided.
Already calculated now previously.
That is the AST required, no, sir?
AST provided, sorry, AST provided. percentage of steel provided. AST calculated. Yeah, AST already calculated. How much it is? Previous step.
Two sir, one. Actual, na sir.
Adhe, adhe, actual. AST provided maadi de yoga.
2138.9 millimeters square.
9, okay. Divided by 2500 into 540. So what is the percentage provided? How much is the percentage you get?
0.158, sir.
Okay,
0.158.
0.158, or you can say 0.16. Call it 0.16%. Okay, then we have to check the tau v value with the tau c. Always tau v should be less than tau c, then only it is safe.
Yes,
correct? Then we have to refer this table now. Okay, so which grade of concrete we have used? M20. Correct? Then what is the percentage of steel we have obtained? Actually provided is, it is between 0.15 and 0.25. So we have to interpolate it, then we have to get the tau c value. So okay, then you can write from table 19, IS 456 2000. Okay, so get for here, I'll write 100 AST by BD, then tau c value. Okay, so here 0.15, what is the tau c value? Then we have 0.16, then it is 0.25. So for 0.15, what is the tau c value? Because it is in between
0.25.
I hope you are understanding.
Yes, sir.
All of you?
Yes, sir.
Because it's a M20 concrete. Suppose if they are using M25, you have to use, refer this table. For table number 4, you have to refer. Since in this problem, the grade of concrete is given M20, and area, that is a percentage of steel provided, we have calculated. Then according to that, you have to take the values of tau c, because it is in between 0.15 and 0.25, because it is a 0.16. For that, we need to calculate what is the tau c value. So for 0.15, what is the tau c value? 0.28. 0.25, what is the tau c value? 0.25.
0.36.
Okay. Now for 0.16, we need to calculate. So what is the value for 0.16? Let us call for this one is the x. Then interpolate it. So I'll get for the interpolation tau c. How to interpolate? Just you multiply this and this, again this and this. So you know interpolation 0.28, I'll write, because I want plus 0.36, this minus this, 0.28, again divided by 0.25, this side 0.25 minus 0.15. Then after that, multiply by for 0.16 minus 0.15, like this. So this is the interpolation you have to do. So what is the answer you get? Linear interpolation. It is a linear interpolation by interpolation.
So 0.288.
0.288 Newton per millimeter square. Okay. So after this, when you get a tau c is 0.228 Newton per millimeter square, check with tau c. So since tau v is less than tau c,
yes sir,
hence safe. Understood, all of you?
Yes sir.
Yes sir.
Okay, so please do it correct interpolation here. So, okay, then you'll get the correct value here. Okay, if you make any mistake in interpolation, again you will get stuck here. Okay, so do it correctly. Then after one way shear, what is the next one? Second one is
two-way.
check for two-way shear. So here the two-way shear will be acting. Draw this one. This is the footing. then in that you draw column. This one is a column. Here the square column we have provided, but here just to call it as one side as a another side as a b, but both are same, but for the calculation purpose just to call one side as a other side as a b, and it will be generally acting at a distance of d by 2 both the direction in x and y direction. This is the critical section for the two-way shear. It will be acting at a distance of d by 2. This is d by 2 all around, d by 2 here also, d by 2, since it is column is just punching the footing here, punch like means all around. It will take the perimeter. This is also d by 2. This is also d by 2. I hope it's visible to you all.
Yes, sir.
Now it's visible, right? You draw it correctly. All around d by 2, d by 2, d by 2 means two-way shear will be acting at a distance of d by 2 from the face of the column. This is the column face. Okay, then after this, so can anyone tell what this distance becomes? Tell me this distance.
Sir, d by 2 plus d by 2 plus 400 mm.
Leave it 400, we'll take it later.
Plus A, sir. D by 2 plus A plus D by 2.
Yes, then shall I write a plus d?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now can anyone tell what is this side?
B plus D.
Yes, b plus d. Now this much will be the punching area. Now a plus d into b plus d is the punching area. Means I hope you're understanding. This is the column, you all can see this one.
Yes, sir.
Okay, it is punching the footing like this, it is going down. How much area is get affecting by that punching? Means the area is this a plus d into b plus d, but actually the critical portion is what? At a distance of d by 2 from the face of the column. Understood? This is two way, means from both the direction, along x direction as well as y direction. And one way shear is where it is critical. One way shear was,
Sir, at the face of the column.
again after telling everything again you are making mistake, where it was acting one way shear?
Sir, at the distance of D.
Where it was?
Distance of B minus B by 2 minus D.
No, at a distance of d from the face of the column.
Oh, yes, sir.
Okay, here the punching shear is acting at a distance of what?
D by 2.
D by 2 from the face of the column. So this is the face of the column, means xx is the face of the column. From the face of the column it is acting at a distance of d by 2 in both the way, both direction, x and y direction. Okay, is it over?
Yes, sir.
Then right here the critical section, right on this one, the critical section for the two-way shear or punching shear, two-way shear or punching shear occurs at a distance of d by 2 from the face of the column, where a and b are the sides of column, where A and B are the sides of the column. Please note it down. So highlight this term. It is acting at a distance of d by 2, punching shear. Is it over?
Yes, sir.
All of you taken this one?
Yes, sir.
The next, coming to the punching area, we need to calculate punching area. Hence punching shear area, punching shear area of footing, punching shear area of footing is given by, shall I write a plus d into b plus d?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, because it is square footing, so then I'll write a plus d square. Why I'm a plus d square I written? Because
Square footing.
a equal to b, no? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Because a equal to b, because here is a plus d plus b plus d. Okay, but b a equal to b, hence I have taken a plus d square. Then a means 0.4. D means correct?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Then what is the area? 0.88. Check this. Meters square. Is it correct? Okay. Now calculate punching shear force. Punching shear force. The formula is factored load minus into bracket factored upward pressure multiplied by punching area of footing. So how much is the factored load? How much is the load coming on the column? It's given
1200,
but you have to make it factored. You have to multiply it by 1.5 into 1200. Okay, minus. So what is the factored upward pressure, soil pressure?
288.
Already it is factored. Okay, multiply. What is the area we have obtained? What is punching area?
0.8836.
Okay. Then what is the answer you get? Punching shear force. That is VU you will get. This is a VU. 1545.52 kilonewton. Right. Correct. This much is the punching shear force. Did you understand why we are deducted here? Factored load minus this much we are deducted. Did you understand? See here. How much is the load coming on the column? See here. This is the column. How much is the load coming? Is it visible? So this is the column. The load coming through the column is how much? 1200. But when you make it factored, that is 1.5. Then there is a upward pressure also. So it is going down and upward pressure is minus. You have to deduct from this load that pressure. That is load. Area multiplied by the pressure will give the load. And this load that minus that load will give the net force which is making a punch. That is called punching shear force. Understood this one?
Yes, sir.
See, this is a factored upward pressure because we know force equal to pressure multiplied by area, because pressure equal to force by area, force equal to pressure into area. So pressure is, this is soil pressure, that is in kilonewton per meter square, multiplied by the punching area, that is in meter square get cancels, we get in kilonewton only, that is the upward force. Okay, so this is the load which is acting down, so this is downward positive, then upward negative, then finally we get, this is the punching shear force. Understood now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Next, coming to next, after this one, so we need to calculate the perimeter of the critical section. Perimeter of the critical section. So calculate perimeter, is it 4 times of A plus D? Perimeter.
Yes, sir.
This one. 1, 2, 3, 4. So perimeter we require. So for this one, let us call this perimeter as a B naught. Let's call it. Then 4 into that is already taken millimeter, 400 plus 540. What is the answer you get here? Just I'm calling a B naught as a perimeter for the critical section. How much you get?
3760
millimeter. This much is the perimeter. Then after the perimeter, then I'll calculate a nominal shear stress. How we calculated for the previous case, one-way shear. Likewise, you have to calculate here also the nominal shear stress. Therefore, nominal shear stress in punching or punching shear stress tau V is computed as, so tau V equal to VU divided by, it's a B naught into D, it's nothing but it's B naught into D, but it is a VU is what, punching shear force, punching shear force divided by. So B naught is what? Perimeter, right? B naught is perimeter.
3760.
Yes. I'll substitute later. I'm writing as the formula. Punching shear force divided by perimeter into what is D? Effective thickness of footing. Correct? Effective thickness of footing. Substitute and get the value.
Sir, 0.761.
What is the answer?
Sir, 0.761.
0.7615. Just check the check all of you. Is it correct? 3760 into 540. 0.76 newton per millimeter square. All of you got same answer?
Yes, sir.
All of you got same answer?
Yes, sir.
Right.
Yes, sir.
Now, okay. So this much, actually, this much is the acting. That is, the punching shear stress is acting in a footing. But how much is permissible according to the code? Then we have to calculate permissible shear stress. Right?
Yes, sir.
Permissible. According to code. Permissible shear stress. Permissible shear stress. That is, we need to calculate permissible shear stress. Let us call the permissible shear stress tau dash C. So, page number 58 IS 456-2000. You can write the page number also. So let us check in page number 58. I hope you all are having the code. So here it is given, everything. So the where the critical section and all, they all given here. Punching shear, where it will be critical and all, this is the diagram given here. See here, punching page number 58. So here they are mentioned. Look here, this section. You all can see this one?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Permissible shear stress. When the shear reinforcement is not provided, the calculated shear stress at the critical section shall not exceed this value, Ks into tau c. Again, coming to the next page, what is Ks? This is the permissible. Okay, this I'll write here. So where this one, tau dash, I'll write Ks into tau c. So here I'm writing here. See, looking here. So this is this much the permissible, but what is K into S? So
0.5 plus.
See, 1 minute. That
0.5 plus beta.
Yes, 0.5 plus beta C.
Beta C.
This is to be taken, and this should not be greater than 1. Here they are given, but not greater than 1. Suppose if you are getting value greater than 1, you have to substitute Ks as 1. Understanding?
Yes, sir.
If I calculate that Ks, then again, beta C. See, beta C is what? It is the ratio of shorter side to longer side column. But in our case, we are providing the square column. So, where I'm writing here, you also write where beta C is ratio of, that is shorter side to longer side of column. Longer side of column. But what is the shorter side in our case? Both side is same, no?
Same. Both are same.
That is 400 pi. What is the value of beta we are getting? 1.
1.
So what is the value of Ks? 0.5 plus 1. What is the answer you get? 1.5. Correct?
Yes, sir.
Then is it greater than 1?
Yes, sir.
Therefore, provide beta equal to how much?
1.
Yes. Provide beta C. Sorry. Well, not beta C. Provide?
Ks.
Ks.
Ks equal to 1. Why 1 is? Because according to the code, what they are saying, it should not be more than 1. Whatever value we calculate. Because suppose if you are getting 0.9, 0.8 from this, then you have to provide 0.8, 0.9 only. Since we are getting more than 1 here, you need to provide 1 only. Okay. And also, what is tau C according to that?
0.25 into square root of FCK.
0.5 root FCK.
That is 0.25 root of FCK. Okay. then 0.25, what is FCK?
20, sir.
20, because M20 concrete grade is given. So FCK is characteristic strength of concrete. Of grade given M20 here, so 20. What is the answer here? This one?
Sir, 1.67 overall answer, told SC.
1.12
Newton per millimeter square we are getting. Then tau C dash, it will be Ks into tau C. 1 into 1.12. Is it 1.12, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Then tau V will be less than tau C. Understood?
Yes, sir.
This only, we have checked it. Okay. So this is tau V is less than tau C, that is tau dash you have taken. Hence, whatever the depth you have provided, how much depth you have provided? 600, right? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Depth of footing, how much you have provided? 600.
600.
Okay, that is including cover. Hence, that depth is adequate in resisting the punching shear. Suppose if you would have provided that 230 or 240, it probably, I think it would have failed here. So there only we increased the depth. So hence we have got safe. Understood?
Yes.
Okay. Now you have to write one line here. Hence provided depth of footing. Provided depth of footing is adequate. Is adequate to resist punching shear force. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So always whenever you calculate depth of the footing or the thickness of the footing by bending moment criteria, by using the bending moment criteria, so there you just increase it. Suppose if you're getting 300, you make it 500, because there in shear criteria it will satisfy the condition. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Next step. Step number four. Step number four, no? Right. Correct? Step number four. Four or five?
Four, sir.
Okay. Then check for development length. Check for development length. So for this you have to refer page number 42, page number 42, IS 456 2000, page number 42. Can you see this formula? How much?
Yes, sir.
Length of bar to be embedded in a concrete to get a better grip, that is the development length. Understood? What is the development length? It's a gripping purpose. How much should be embedded? Is it clear?
Yes,
yes, sir.
That development length, but this is the formula to be given. But this pi is nominal diameter of the bars what we are providing for the footing. Sigma s is the stress in bar at the section considered at a design load. And tau BD is the designed bond stress, which is given in the next table. Here it is given the designed bond stress, how much to be taken for the different grades of a concrete. And the minimum grade of concrete to be used for the RCC is M20. Remember, it should not be used below that. Understood? For RCC, minimum grade is M20. It should not provide M15, M10, no. It should be minimum M20. That's why it has started from M20, 25, 30, 35 and above, right? So this is a designed bond stress. Okay. So in our case, what is the grade of concrete we are using?
M20.
For M20, this is the designed bond stress to be taken. And this is the formula to be used for the LD. So now I'll write. I'll write here. Sufficient. For your information, sufficient development length should be available for the reinforcement from the critical section, from the critical section. So here the critical section considered for LD, that is LD means development length, is that of flexure, means bending moment, where the bending moment you have considered critical, means from that point you have to take the development length LD. Therefore, the development length for 16 mm die, because we have used the 16 mm die bars, right?
Yes, sir.
We have used 16 mm die. Okay, 16 mm die bars is given by the formula is LD equal to 0.87 fy pi divided by 4 into tau bd. See, so here I have taken 0.87. The formula is that like that only. So this is one. See, so sigma is a stress in a bar that is to be taken 87% of the. I hope you are understanding here, all of you.
Yes, sir.
See, I'll write here just a minute. This sigma s. Sigma s, is it visible?
Yes sir.
See, this is what stress in a bar considered at design load. Okay, then we are taking it is 0.87% of the yield stress of the bar. 87%, that's why I have taken 0.87 here. This is 0.87. understood all of you?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, 0.87 times of Fy into pi. Then here 0.87 into 415 into 16 is the diameter. 4 multiplied by. What is tau into BD?
Sir, 1.2
for 21. How much it is? All of you, 1. Just try to understand 1. Here.
1.2.
1.2, correct? Huh? Correct, 1.2. But again, you have to read it below. Look here. For a deformed bars conforming to IS 1786, these values shall be increased by 60%. Means we are using HYST bars in a concrete. Suppose if you are using a mild steel, then you can take it as the same. Since you are using HYST bar, you have to increase this value by 60%. I hope you understood.
Yes, sir.
Any doubt here?
No, sir.
So this is okay. Then after this one, after taking these all values for a deformed bars, deformed means this HYST bars only, what you are using, ribbed bars. Deformed bars conforming to this one, these values shall be increased by 60%. Straight away you have to increase that by 60%. Then how I can write now? Shall I write 1.6 into 1.2?
Yes, sir.
Means I increased it by 60%. 1.6 times I increased. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Because if I multiply it by 1, it means the same value. You have to means I'm increasing it by 60%. That's why I take it as 1.6. Any doubt here?
No, sir.
Then you, while taking, you have to take it. Don't take only 1.2. You have to take it 1.6 times. Okay. Means 60%, that is factor of safety, what we are taking. So what is the length we are getting here? Development length required is 752.18 millimeter. This is the required development length. Then how much we have provided, we have to check. All of you taken this one?
Yes sir.
Coming to the next one, how much we have provided or how much is available, we'll check it. So this much is required. This much is required. Assuming here you write already we have taken the cover. Assuming 60 mm side cover we already taken. Available anchorage length. How much is available? So we have to take. Means we are taking it from, just a minute. So look here, bending moment criteria. Here, so this is the bending moment criteria. See, here is the bending moment criteria. Bending moment, where it is acting? Bending moment, where it is acting? At the face of the column, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so from the face of the column, how much to be taken this side? That is the development length. So leaving the cover, so the available length is, shall I write B minus B by 2 minus D? Understood this one? Sorry, minus side cover. Understood this one?
Yes, sir.
So leaving the cover, is 60 mm, we are left up to here. Already available length is B minus B by 2 from the face of the column. This is understood. Then I'll write 2500 minus 400 divided by 2. What is the side cover? 60. You may take 50 also cover, not less than that. Okay. So what is the answer we are getting? This is available anchorage length, 990. This much value we have provided, which is greater than LD. So LD required is how much?
Yes, sir.
Required is this much. How much? 752. But already we have provided how much?
990.
Is it safe or not safe?
Sir, it is safe, sir.
Hence safe. Understood? Suppose if not safe, if you are getting this length lesser than this one, what is to be done? If not safe, provide bent in reinforcement. In reinforcement. Understood? Means suppose if you are providing like this bars, what you have to do? You have to provide a bent like this to increase the length. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Is it clear? See, this is, we have obtained this much is the development length. If you are not, means if this is not safe, if you are getting this length is lesser than the LD what we have calculated, then you have to provide a bent in a steel to increase the length. Automatically it gets satisfied. I hope understood.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then the last step is bearing stress. The far last is the bearing stress. Check for the bearing stress. That is the last step. Step number 5. Okay. Check for bearing stress. How much is the check for the bearing stress? So here in in page number 63. Page number 63. Look here. Here it is there. Footings. For footings it is there. So these are the guidelines for the design of footing. Here you can read all guidelines given. Here, transfer of load at the base of the column. Look here, I'll read it. The compressive stress in a concrete at the base of the column or pedestal shall be considered as being transferred by bearing to the top of the supporting pedestal or footing. The bearing pressure on the loaded area shall not exceed the permissible bearing stress in direct compression multiplied by the value equal to root of A1 by A2, but not greater than the 2. This is the condition. What is A1? Supporting area. So what is A1? A1 is the supporting area for a bearing of footing, which in sloped or stepped footing may be taken as the area of the lower base of the largest frustum of a pyramid or cone contained wholly within the footing and having for its upper base the area actually loaded and having the side slope of 1 vertical to 2 horizontal. And A2 is what? Loaded area of the column base. For working stress method of design, permissible bearing stress on a full area of concrete shall be taken as the 0.25 FCK for limit state method. And design the permissible bearing stress shall be 0.45 FCK. So this is the condition they given. How much should be the bearing stress at the base of the column? Then we have to calculate according to this guidelines. We need to calculate the bearing stress. So just you note it down the page number. This is the page number 65. Then we'll calculate how much is the bearing stress at the base of the footing. Now I'll write here. The load is assumed. The load is assumed. The same guideline I'll write here. The load is assumed to disperse. Disperse from the base of column to the base of footing at the ratio of 2 horizontal to 1 vertical. Hence the side of the hence 2 horizontal to like this. This is a column and this is the footing. I hope you are understanding. This is the load coming. P, how it is transferring? It is transferring like this. But when you take the slope of this one, it will be what? 2 horizontal to 1 vertical. I hope you are understanding.
Yes, sir.
See the load. And now I have to calculate what is the bearing stress here. How much is this bearing stress here? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Any doubt here? This slope should be 2 horizontal to 1 vertical. In this way, it has to transfer the load. The load is assumed to disperse. Here it is given. Look here where it is given. 1 vertical to 2 horizontal. Whatever the footing should be. Means whether you provide it is a stepped footing, sloped footing, whatever the footing you provide. So, but it should be transfer the load to horizontal to 1 vertical slope. Is it clear?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now what I'll do here, because here they are given this formula I'll take. Okay. According to that, I'll calculate first one. Okay. So what is A1 here? A1, I'll write. A1 is area of footing and A2 is area of column base. Area of column base. I hope you're understanding.
Yes, sir.
See, A1 is area of footing, A2 is area of column base. Then what is A1? Is it 2.5 into 2.5?
Yes, sir.
See, this is 6.25 meter square. What is A2?
0.4 into 0.4.
How much is the area? 0.16. Then what is the ratio? Square root of A1 by A2? Root of 6.25 divided by 0.16. How much you are getting? How much you get?
15.62.
It's the square root. Check it.
6.25.
So which is greater than 2? But here they given.
Yes, sir.
But what is they are given? This term should not be greater than 2. Understood? Understood this one?
Yes.
Then what is the value to be provided? What is the value to be provided now? A1 by A2. Shall I provide 2? Because it should not be greater than 2.
Yes, sir.
Since in our case, we are getting more than 2. So we should not provide this 6.25. We have to provide only 2. Hence, I'll write here. Hence, limit the value of, according to the code, limit the value of root of A1 by A2 equal to 2. Then permissible bearing stress. How much is the permissible bearing stress according to the code to be taken? for working stress method, this is for limit state method. We are doing the limit state method. How much should be taken for limit state?
0.45 into FCQ.
Yes, permissible bearing stress. Permissible bearing stress. Permissible bearing stress will be 0.45 FCK, 0.45 FCK multiply by A1 by A2. This you have to multiply. So tell me, answer 0.45 into 20. And how much is the this ratio to be taken?
2, sir.
2. So what is the answer?
18.
18, correct. So this is, this much is a permissible. I hope you understood, all of you.
Yes, sir.
Now we'll calculate how much is the actual acting in our case. Is it over?
Yes, sir.
This is permissible. Now we'll calculate actual bearing stress. Actual bearing stress. Then directly we get factored load divided by area of the column base. Factored load is how much? 1.5 into 1200 into 10 raised to 3. What is the column base? Means here actually we are calculating the bearing stress. Here at this position we are calculating. What is the concrete column base? Here bearing.
Sir, 400 by 400.
400 by 400.
0.16.
Yes. 400 by 400. Correct. Then tell me the answer. Check it once. How much is the answer? What is the answer?
11.25.
Is it 11.25?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Somebody told 7 point. Is it 7 point or?
No, sir. She is correct. It is 11.25.
11.25.
Okay. Then this is actual. Is it less than 18? Means permissible?
Yes, sir.
See, this much is the permissible according to, but in our case, I am getting how much bearing stress?
11.25.
Safe or not safe?
Safe.
Safe, sir.
Hence, safe. Okay. So this ends the design. The next is the detailing part. Means the reinforcement to be provided. That is to be drawn. The reinforcement here. Just the reinforcement details. Finally, you have to show that reinforcement details. Reinforcement details. Just draw the column like this, then draw the footing. This is the column. Then here, draw this longitudinal bar, then transverse bars to be shown. How it is to be shown, transverse bar? This is the longitudinal bar. Dot. Does. Like this. And just you bent here. And this overall depth. How much is the overall depth we have provided?
600, sir.
600. That is to be shown. And these bars. What is the spacing we have provided? For both.
235, sir.
Yes, you're right. 16 dia at 235 center to center. Correct? Huh? Both we have provided 235, right? Yes, sir. No.
Yes. Yes, sir.
Then you draw plan. Just one line. Plan. So in plan, what you have to show? You show the column. Is like this, then you show it bars. So here one bar and like this, just in this way also we are providing, this way also we are providing like this. Only one bar you show it. And what is this width we have provided? Is it 2500, right?
Yes, sir.
And this is correct, huh?
Yes, sir.
Okay, this much you have to show at last. I hope you understood this design. This is single column, that is square footing. The next we'll take the rectangular column. This is without eccentricity, then comes with eccentricity. You have to practice this problem. Any doubt here?
No, sir.
Okay. Right. With this, we'll wind up the today's session and practice this problem. And I'll give you one assignment, rectangular footing. Please try this one. Rectangular column and rectangular footing. Design. Please note it down. Design a rectangular footing for a column size of 500 mm by 300 mm to carry a load of 1200 kilonewton. The SBC of the soil is 220 kilonewton per meter square. Use M20 grade concrete and Fe415 steel. Have you taken this one?
Yes, sir.
Taking, sir.
Take, please take. And try this problem. Provide rectangular footing. Don't provide a square footing here. Provide rectangular footing. Design a rectangular footing for a column size of 500 mm by 300 mm to carry a load of 1200 kN. The SBC of the soil is 220 kN per meter square. Use M20 grade concrete and Fe415 steel. Again, the same steps to be followed. First, you need to calculate the area of the footing. Then you have to proportion it. Means you have to calculate the size L and B. For L and B, what you have to take? You have to take the ratios. Means L by B, it should be same as small L by B. This capital L by B, like this, means this is footing L into B, and this one is small L into B. The ratio should be same for these two. L by B is equal to L by B. Then this is given 500 by 300. Then whatever the length, you will be getting length in terms of B. So you will get in terms of B. Then area, whatever area you get, you have to provide L into B. Then already you know the area, then you will get the other dimensions. I hope you understood.
Sir.
Yes, sir.
All of you understood or not?
Yes, sir.
I'll repeat it once. You have to calculate the area. How you calculate the area? Load by?
Load by
SBC, sir.
Correct? Huh? Load by SBC, you calculate area. But in case of square footing, what you did? We have taken L equal to B, correct? Huh? Then yes, there sir. We calculate L equal to B equal to square root of A. Because both the dimensions were taken the same because we have provided a square footing. But here I'm asking you to provide rectangular footing. You cannot take the same. L should be different and B should be different. Correct? Huh? For that reason, what you have to do is you take the ratios of this. L by B is equal to small L by B. L by B means small L into B. These ratios I'll get in terms of B. Then area already calculated, substitute here, you will get one dimensions. Substitute in other, you will get the L into B. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Then,
yes, sir.
Then that footing dimensions you provide and follow the same steps what we have followed in this square footing. Try this one. We'll discuss in the next class. Okay. You try this one. Those who have solved, you can share that problem here and just I'll check the answer here itself. Okay. Right, you give your attendance and leave the meeting.